Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So this is my second video in the channel, and today I'm gonna be doing shading effects. Shading effects for a drawing, actually. Basically, that it's not that hard and not that easy, because most of you feel that it's really easy, most of you feel that it's really hard. So I'm telling you guys, there is nothing called as hard or easy. I know I've already said it, that it's not that hard or not that easy. That means it's medium, but still, never mind. There's nothing called as hard or easy. All it is that we need ample amounts of practice. That makes us that makes us better at this drawing and all. First of all, coming back to the context, we'll be doing shadow effects. As we know, there are several shades. First one is dark to light. And so now that we figured out what are the shades of the shadow effects, we will be good to go. So first of all we need is a little blunt pencil, so that we'll be able to do the shading and all efficiently, because you know, you just see look at this. A blunt pencil can do more a better shading effect than a sharp pencil. Now, let's just jump straight into it. First of all, we need to know where the light is falling. According to that, we will be able to do the shadow effects. I'm taking my light from here. The light will be coming from here. So we need to draw the shadow effects in. We need to do the shadow effects with respect to this light. So let's start the shading effect from this side, because the light is falling over on this figure from this side, this part of the page. I'll quickly let the hair be black. I know I didn't do it black. I'll just quickly do it. But if it's black, we will know where can we draw the shadow effect, because we can shade a little. We can do the darker shading for that. I'll quickly show it in a minute. Okay, here we have the shabby colored hair. Anyways, let's start. So now that we have the dark shaded hair, we can start the shading. So we will do the dark shading from this point of view, and we will shade till such an extent that the darkness will blend into the darkness of the hair. See, just like this. So you need to put a little pressure. We need to put a little pressure, and then we have to leave the pressure of shading until this point of view. And now, as we can see that the dark shaded shadow effect is blending into the hair. Okay, now that we have shaded the hair, it's time for the skin. So as we know, we have to leave this part untouched, because the light is falling on this part and we don't want shadow on this part. And as the hair is blocking this part of the skin, the forehead mainly, we will do light shading, just a light shading around. There we go, perfect. I have a random face, you can draw any face if you want to. Okay. So I have shaded lightly towards this point of the chin. Just shade lightly, lightly. And on this eye, we have to do with utmost care, we have to shade only a little bit of it, so that we can have a shady view on the light on the eye. But remember, we don't need to shade on this eye, because it's on the other part of the face which we don't need to shade. So till the chin, bring it down like this, and at the neck, shade it dark. Heavy shading is required, because the face is covering the neck. The chin part is mostly covering the neck. So it's okay if you shade even on this part. See, done. So we can shade the skin which is on the collarbone, because to show the denty effect of that. And there we have it, perfect masterpiece. And on the nose, we can, if you have a pointy nose, if you have a nose like this, then we need to shade like give a little bit of shading like this. So if you have a blunt nose like this, then we need, then also we should do a little bit of it, a little bit of shading on this part of the nose, and then a little more shading on the below part of the nose, because the nose is a little blunt and it will be, it is not that pointy. Anyways, forget it. It's the same actually. So never mind. It's for the face, not for the nose. Okay. And there we have it, guys. Perfect shadow effect. And thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know in the comments. And if you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will be able to help you guys. Please just put it in the comment section down below. And please subscribe, share, and we'll see you for the next video. Goodbye.